The equation mu is equals to square root of n into n plus 2 formula. It is called as spin only formula to calculate magnetic momentum of given set of d block ions or d block atoms, their respective ions. Come to this. Once again, what is n here? Number of single electrons or number of single unpaired electrons. For example, let us have, I would like to calculate magnetic momentum of ion in which the configuration of ion having d phi. So d phi configuration means the d orbital completely, or the d orbital in such category is half filled with electrons. Half filled electrons means the 5 suborbitals of d orbital with single electron. In such case, how many single unpaired electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in such case, n will become 5. So we can substitute mu is equals to square root of 5 into 5 plus 2. So what is that value? Square root of 5 into 5 plus 2. So 5 plus 2, 7 plus 7 into 5. Square root of 35, which is having nearly 5.75. 5.75 boromagnetons or bore magnetons. So this is about magnetic character of d block elements. Next one. When these d block elements formation of colored ions. What is this concept? When metal complexes or metal ions or metals of d block elements dissolved in solvent or different types of solutions, here they are going to form some electron interchange takes place. That means electron from one suborbital jumps to another suborbital. So for these transitions, they are going to require energy. That energy probably identified by some visible light around the chemical substances. So while they are going to observe certain wavelength light, they are going to show different types of colors. So that means formation of colored ions due to absorption of visible light takes place or identified by d block elements. Next one, the most important phenomenon or the most important character of d block elements is formation of complexes. As they are metals and with less ionization enthalpy values, and most importantly, all the d block elements will exhibit, they are with variable oxidation states. What is variable oxidation state? One element consists of more than two, more than three types of oxidation state. Such condition is called as variable oxidation state. And due to presence of d orbitals, once again with the less ionization enthalpy when compared to main group elements and metallic character, and they are with high variable oxidation state and presence of d orbital, they readily react with some electron donor species to form metal complexes. They readily binds with Lewis bases. What are Lewis bases? Electron pair donors. They readily accepts electrons from electron pair donors like Lewis bases or ligands to form metal complexes or complex molecules. How it takes place? Generally, the chemical species which wants to donate electron pair are called as ligands. These ligands are going to donate their electrons towards the empty d orbitals of metals to form metal complexes. How the formation of metal complexes takes place and what is the oxidation state, general aspects and general characteristics of metal complexes will be discussed in that run after completion of the topics related to D block and F block elements in a separate topic, separate chapter. But before going to this, let us have an example for metal complexes. FeCn taken 6 minus 3. FeCl taken 6 minus 2, CONH3 taken 6 plus 2, etc. So all these are the examples for metal complexes resulting from transition metals or D block elements. And one more important phenomenon regarding D block elements is catalytic property. What is this? Catalytic. Catalytic property or catalytic properties. Here, almost all transition metals consist of d block elements or d orbitals. Such d orbitals may be completely filled or half filled or partially filled with electrons. So such character will offer to works them or to offer them as catalytic behavior. That means in some of the chemical reactions, some of the D block elements and D block elements complexes, compounds of D block elements used as catalysts. So the previously explained topics, preparation of concentrator or preparation of sulfuric acid by contact method, the used catalyst is vanadium 5 oxide. Examples for catalysts, V2O5, vanadium 5 oxide, sometimes iron plus 3 or iron compounds, MnO2, manganese dioxide. These type of species are used as catalyst and means the D block elements are their atomic form or ionic form, sometimes their compounds also exhibit catalytic behavior and used as catalysts in chemical reactions. Only the reason why they offer additional property is due to presence of d orbitals. And next one, what will be expected during the catalytic reaction? First, the reactant molecules are converted into product molecules. When the same takes place, first the reactant molecules are absorbed onto the catalytic surface. When the absorption takes place, the bond strength becomes weakened in the substrate molecules. They can easily convert into products with less activation energy. That means, whenever the chemical reaction takes place in the presence of catalyst, it decreases activation energy of that reaction. Means, easy conversion of reactant into products takes place. This is catalytic property of D block elements. And next one, the special type of compounds, formation of interstitial complex formation of interstitial compounds. So what are interstitial compounds? Sometimes, as I explained just now, what are interstitial compounds and how they are going to result are, all the D block elements are metals. They will exhibit desired metallic geometry. Like some of the metals will exhibit HCP, BCC and X, etc. So all such metallic character are identified with metals belongs to D block category. Here, in such metals, for example, titanium hydrogen, so which is 1.17. So what will be the expected one onto the titanium complex or titanium metal geometry or complex, the hydrogen molecules are inserted. So unexpectedly in different quantities. So during this TIC, and similarly some complexes are there, we can write it as Fe3H. These are the examples for interstitial compounds. So once again, what are interstitial compounds are other elements, main group elements like hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon, when unexpectedly enters into the crystal lattice of these elements. So they inserted into the crystal lattice without additional bond formation. There is no covalent bond, there is no coordination covalent bond, etc. They just inserted into the crystal lattice of these D block elements. Then the resulting compounds are called as interstitial compounds. So in this interstitial compounds, the two elements are mixed together in random proportions, where the special characters of these interstitial compounds resulting when major group elements when inserted into the crystal lattice of these metal complexes are they are with hard character. They show very hard character. They are simple compounds with high melting points are also there. And these are chemically inert. The interstitial compounds resulting from D block elements are chemically inert. And also they are with good conductivity character. So these are most important four marks question. The D block elements are transition elements. Transition metals can form interstitial compounds. Once again, when main group elements like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen atoms unexpectedly enters into the crystal lattice of D block elements, they inserted or incorporated into the crystal lattice, then the resulting compounds are called as interstitial compounds. Example for these interstitial compounds are these. So here in the interstitial compounds, the quantity of D block elements and main group elements are random. That means there is no proper proportion of quantity identified between D block elements and hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, etc. So these will have some special categories, like they are hot in character and with high melting point. These are chemically inert. That means they are less reactive when compared to simple metal complexes. When compared to these, they are with good conductors or good conductivity character. This is about formation of interstitial compounds by D block elements. And next one, formation of alloys. So what is alloys here? Formation of alloys. Here, when two or more types of D block elements or metals blend together, then the resulting chemical species are called as alloys. That means in alloys, two or more different types of D block elements are mixed together in a different proportion to produce a new species. The produced new species, new chemical substance is called as alloys. When compared to ordinary metals, the alloys will have strong, stiff and good conductivity character and less oxidative character when compared to simple iron. Mostly manganese, nickel, iron, copper, chromium, etc. These elements most widely used to prepare alloys like brass, bronze, etc. So one more most important alloy used in our daily life is stainless steel. So all these are the chemical composition resulting from D block elements.